I am also informed, even if you have a corrupt official, you discipline and their services were terminated, they get rewards from some inmates who was connected to this, can I say, contravention of the contrabands. And when they are even not in the service of the department anymore, then they get the reports, rewards from the inmate. And can I say, the criminals in our facilities. So it's a huge problem. I think that there should be some or other system monitoring these officials when they were actually fired from the department. And if they are still getting some rewards, then we must... The Department of Correctional Services deals with the matter of contrabands in terms of Section 119A of the Correctional Services Act, which stipulates that no person may, without authority, supply or convey to any offender a document intoxicating liquor, dacha, money, or any other article. Dealing with the smuggling of any contrabands receives attention by performing security operations, supported by the implementation of technologies such as integrated security systems. Correctional centers implement security standard operating procedures, known as SOPs, prevention strategies, security awareness sessions, as well as security meetings on a routine basis to prevent and defect the influx of contraband into correctional facilities. Investigations are instituted by heads of correctional facilities to establish how contrabands are found in correctional facilities that will normally include root cause analysis as well as the methodology of such actions. Requisite remedial action is taken resulting from the outcomes of such investigations. Heightened security measures are put in place at access control points, searching and recording of all persons entering or leaving correctional facilities starts from the management area, reserved access point. Management also conducts surprise visits at access control points to monitor the compliance. The department is currently investigating the possibility of implementing technologies to deal with and manage risk associated with electronic communication devices within the precincts of the correctional centres. I thank you.
Thank you very much, Honourable Minister. I now call upon Honourable Noe. If there is any follow-up question, you may ask.
Thank you, Chairperson of the House, and thank you, Minister. Your last statement actually is around the follow-up question regarding the technology systems that you intend to implement within the presence. Maybe what one could then ask, if ever you have any time frame as to when you think you will be able to have this technology system within the presence.
Thank you, Honourable Member. If you ask a time frame, I don't have a specific time frame to say from this date to that date, but my answer is as soon as possible. That is what we want. And I also want to say that we must remember, when it comes to technology, unfortunately, it costs quite a lot of money. You have quite sophisticated technology, but we must also remember, for instance, let's take jammers. Let's take the Goodwood facility. If you put a jammer in there, then you have complaints from the community because they're close to the facility, as well as the highway, the N1. Say, for instance, there's an accident in that area. Then they say that, it's a problem. It's an emergency and they cannot make any calls. But there is quite sophisticated technology that can I say, counter that problem. But it costs quite a lot of money. And just to inform the House that for the last 5 years, the budget of correctional services was cut with 11.7 billion rand. So we do look at these matters. And I want to say again, on the time frame, as soon as possible, we're looking at that.
Thank you very much, Honourable Minister. The next follow-up question is from DA, Honourable Godsell.
Minister, yes, with reference to the prison raids, your commissioner has recently said that search and seizures are done regularly. But we'd like to get your assurance that these searches happen more frequently. And more importantly, that the corrupt officials that enable these items to be smuggled in and out of the prison cells are brought to book. Will you give an undertaking to this House today to report on the outcomes of the disciplinaries and other processes against the correctional services officials and employees who are responsible for the smuggling?
Thank you, Chair, Honourable Member. Yes, we are at this moment busy with a project to see that when we have these seizures and these raids, that officials who are involved in that, and I want to put it quite clearly, it's just logic that these contrabands can actually only enter into our facilities when there is colluding with some of the officials. And I will give report on those. I can give you some. Firstly, if I look at the Free State and Northern Cape, and I refer to the total number of seizures or searches conducted from April 24 to August 24, two officials were caught in possession of a cell phone inside the unit. One official is on suspension and the other official was given a final written warning. Also, as far as the offender is concerned, one offender was found with a cell phone in his possession. He was segregated for 7 days and lost the amenities. And six offenders were found guilty after the departmental investigation privilege of making calls and visits were stopped for 42 days. So yes, we are taking steps, and I will from time to time update, because it is important, and I said it on many times, a priority is that there must be consequence management, and therefore we do follow up some of these. There are some problems. There were cases which I inherited where there were no steps taken, but I will also attend to that as far as that is concerned. Thank you. Sorry.
Thank you very much. Is there a follow-up question from Honourable Siwisa from EFF?
Thank you, Chair. That's right. No, thank you, Minister. The question that was asked, I was supposed to ask it, but maybe let me rephrase the question that I am going to ask. Taking into consideration, irrespective of whatever the correctional services is doing, to do a search and seize, but for some reason, these items still find themselves inside. So department cannot be reactive, but needs to be proactive, which means that there need to be measures put in place, because some of these people that have got access to cell phones, they are actually opening up for them, because if there were proper measures put in place, we wouldn't be having the issue of Thabo Besta. But leaving that, most of the children are on social media, which means that some of these perpetrators are getting ways of communicating with kids on social media. So what measures are actually going to be put in place to ensure that even those corrupt officials, yes, you are going to take action against officers that are corrupt, but what measures are going to be put in place to ensure that none of these items find themselves to actually even find itself in the vicinity of the prisons itself before they can even reach the cells, but there at the entrance point, because that's where the problem is. So what measures are going to be put in place? Thank you.
You respond, Honourable Minister.
Thank you, Honourable Chair. Honourable Member, you're quite right. And your question is, what measures are we going to take? I think we must be honest towards each other. You will never 100% stop this process because it's part of corruption. The items on the contraband can only get its way into the facility when you have corrupt officials. If I look at the measures, as I said, security measures, and I've also said from time to time, there are surprise visits to see whether the security measures are executed correctly. But just to say something, I am also informed, even if you have a corrupt official, you discipline and their services were terminated, they get rewards from some inmates who was connected to this, contravention of the contrabands. And when they are even not in the service of the department anymore, then they get the rewards from the inmate. And the criminals in our facilities. So it's a huge problem. And I say always, if we know how they go at work to ensure that they get these contrabands, then you can start taking steps. But there is one problem. The moment an official is not in the service of the department anymore, we can't do anything. But what is important, I will have to take or have conferences or meetings with the Minister of Police. I think that there should be some or other system monitoring these officials when they were actually fired from the department. And if they are still getting some rewards, then we must ensure that there are specific steps. We must make examples of these people, but that is part of the problem. Thank you, Honourable Chair.
Thank you very much, Minister. Is there a follow-up question, Honourable Mokoena? Over to you.
Thank you, Chair. Good afternoon, Chair. Good afternoon, Minister. My question to you, Minister, is in regards to the escape of Thabo Bester in one of your prison facilities in Mongabong. My question is, what has the department done so far with regards to the service provider that was responsible at the time of his escape? Details, please, as to, because we heard in the news that the service provider still continued working and providing the services. What has happened so far? What has happened to the officials that have been found to have helped him to escape as well? Just put us into confidence about that matter. Thank you.
Thank you, Honourable Chair, through you, Honourable Member. Let me start by saying that the whole G4S issue and Thabo Bester at this stage, we are in a litigation process. So, unfortunately, it is, like they say, sub judice. I cannot go into those details. What I said, it is quite clear from the Thabo Bester situation that there is an idea, specifically when it comes to the public, that you must outsource to private companies when it comes, for instance, and ensure that there's less corruption. Now, I think the Thabo Bester matter actually proved that that is not necessarily the case as far as, privatization, or using private companies to do that. I also want to put on record, I said the first facility I want to visit is the Mahong, as well as Grootvlei. I had appointments for 2 times, and unfortunately I had to cancel that, because I said I want to see the CEO of the private company, and I want to hear exactly what they did. For instance, it is the employee, or the employees are their employees and not ours, but what steps have been taken. So unfortunately, if you ask what steps have been taken, I can't answer you on that, but be assured that I want to know that, but also remember it is outside the authority of the correctional services. Thank you, Honourable Chair.